pastor of worship and music here at First Baptist Church of San Antonio. This is your first time to visit us here. Welcome. We are so grateful to have you with us. You're in for a real treat, I promise you. Just a few housekeeping things that we always take care of before our recitals. Please make sure that your cell phones are turned off. We are really grateful to have Barry Brake here and TPR. We're going to record this and hopefully share some of these selections in the future on TPR. So we don't want him to be interrupted by cell phones or anything like that. And it's also a good reminder just to be present. Be here in the moment and enjoy this beautiful music in this beautiful space. If you don't have a church home, we just would love to get to know you and get to be part of your worship experience. This weekend is Christmas. Today is when my Christmas shopping starts, so that's keeping up that tradition. On Saturday evening, we're going to have a couple services that I want you to know about. At 4:45 in the sanctuary, we'll have our annual candlelight memorial service where we honor those that have left us in the recent years. It's just a good service of memory. Following that at 5:30, we have our candlelight Christmas service, Christmas Eve service, which is a beautiful time of church family together where we sing, we read scripture, and just remember the season for what it means. Then Christmas Day, we will have worship service here at 11 o'clock in the sanctuary. We would love for you to be a part of that. If you're away or not able to be with us at 11, we're live at KSAT 12. And then at noon at KSAT 12, will be a rebroadcasting of our Christmas at First presentation, which was a wonderful service a couple weeks ago. So if you weren't able to be a part of that, or if you just want to get some more Christmas music, let me encourage you to tune in for that. We've already got planned a fantastic lineup for our Lent series, which will begin at the end of February, beginning of March. So at noon throughout the Lenten season, we'll have concerts in here just as we had for Advent. And if you want to know about those, if you'll take a minute to put your email address on one of these cards and drop it in the basket on the way out, we'll just let you know when those concerts are coming up and what those are to be. So we want to keep you in the loop for those. Also, always, the First Fine Arts Series is an endeavor to bring about the best music in this space. We believe great faith deserves great art. And so the First Fine Arts Series is not supported by the general budget of First Baptist Church. It is all come from our patrons and our supporters. So if you like what you hear and you'd like more of it, I would encourage you to consider giving on your way out. If you want to write a check, you can write it to First Baptist Church and then just indicate First Fine Arts in the memo. But regardless, we want you this day to be blessed by some wonderful music. Jeff Castle and Castle Brass are heroes of ours, and we've had them several times to come out and play a part of this service. And individually, they've played with our orchestras in big events. So it is a privilege to help welcome Jeff Castle and Castle Brass. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. As Dr. Hudson said, we're Castle Brass. Now, I have always told audiences the story behind this. I won't get too into it with you all. It's very typical for a trumpet player to name a group after himself. I assure you, I did not want to do that, but I was convinced by one of the co-founders of the group, Gary Poffenbarger. He's like, oh, it's a cool name, do it. And I heard that from several people. It is not about me at all. It is about just having fun, playing brass music, bringing some joy and Christmas cheer to all of you. So please sit back and enjoy. That first piece was a piece by J.S. Bach, and it's called My Spirit Be Joyful. The interesting thing about Bach, I think he had like 21 or 23 kids.
22
kids. And we think that piece was written right after the last one left home. So it's a really joyous piece, and that's why we start our holiday program with it. The next piece is a beautiful arrangement of the first Noel. So please sit back today and enjoy the music. Now, he's a multi-talented guy. He can sing, he can play the trombone, he can literally do anything. So we thought, what better way to feature all this amazing talent than to have him play the jingle bells?
Thank you.
introduce a little bit about the members of Castle Brass today. I spent 21 years on active duty in the Air Force Band, and I had the honor of spending the last several years of my career with Hughey Hancock, a beautiful French horn player. And I'm going to let him talk about this for like 30 seconds. 30 seconds. Hughey, what have you been doing since you retired?
So I retired in 2020. This is 2022, right? So yeah.
It's a part of life we all have.
Yeah. So I retired July 1st of 2020 and had some crazy notion that I should go to nursing school. So I enrolled in a 16-month nursing program. We just finished that last week. And
congratulations. And Erick and I, we worked together in Alaska in a group called Alaska Brass. We spent, 1 or 2 years together, 2011 to 2013. And then we both moved to Texas after that. And I asked you to tell us what you're up to these days, because he also just retired from the Dallas Bar
Band. Yeah, so I separated from active duty, the band, in 2015 and went to the Air National Guard Band. Since that time, I've been doing that part-time, but also working on my healthcare administration master's, and I now work over at the VA with the South Texas Veterans Healthcare System. And I retired from the Air National Guard in April after 26 years.
Well, many of you know Gary Poffenbarger, and I can tell you he doesn't retire, he'll never retire, he works everywhere all the time. He's the tuba professor of every school in the area.
What schools do you teach at?
Well, mostly it's in UTSA, and then I have a couple of students at Trinity, and I have a couple of students at Orban. So that keeps me busy, and my beautiful wife and my five kids who are spread all over the globe, and I go to church here, which is the best ever, you know?
It's great. Gary's also retired from the Air Force. What is it called? The
Air Force Academy Band?
Academy Band in Colorado Springs. I was teaching at Reagan High School. We have some students here from Reagan High School. And I have heard through mutual social media things that this really great trumpet player was moving to San Antonio. And then I just happened to walk into school and then to teach, and there he was giving a master class. Dan Orban is tell us about your career.
Sure. Actually, I was just thinking about when we were playing that song, like, I retired from the Marine Corps almost 30, over 30 years, let's say. And what I did was play at the White House. And I played at all the dinners and all the festivities that the White House gives. So I played for many, many presidents. And I was just thinking how this hall that you guys have here sounds just like the foyer, and it does, of the White House. So if you've never been to the White House, now you can actually come here. So I was very fortunate to do my career with them. I had my own brass quintet for 35 years before that, I guess. And now Jeff has kind of got me playing trumpet so when I got back into town, I retired. I was just going to swim in my pool and do all that stuff, but he got me back playing the trumpet. So here I am. Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you. Thank you.
Church in Oberndorf to perform their own work joined by a local choir. The sounds of this brand new carol was immortalized as it broke the silence of that silent night.
Thank you.
stick around. I think there's a lunch afterwards, and come by and say hello to us. So thank you very much, and have a Merry Christmas.